Niagara. Unreal Engine's next-generation visual effects system. It can be used to build almost any effect that you can imagine. Niagara simulations are composed of four parts: emitters, modules, parameters, and systems. Emitters are the foundation for particle simulations in Niagara. They're made up of stages, which contain programmable code blocks called modules. The execution flow of these modules follows the stack paradigm. This means that they're executed in order from top to bottom. Every module used in an emitter gets assigned to a stage that describes when that module gets executed. For example, modules that need to be executed when a particle spawns should be added to the particle spawn stage. A unique and useful feature of emitters is that their produced simulations can be applied directly onto multiple render targets. Taking a firework effect as an example, you could create a single emitter whose simulation results in the movement of the firework, and then provide it with two renderers, a sprite renderer for the spark, and a ribbon renderer for the stream of light following that spark. Next, we have modules. They are mostly used to operate on data and provide you with the ability to perform a wide range of custom functionality. Modules are built with a shading language called HLSL, but can also be built visually in Niagara module scripts, a node-based visual scripting system, resembling but not exactly like Unreal's blueprint system. But don't let this scare you, as the engine comes with many built-in modules, which can be used to perform most operations that you may need to create the effects that you desire. Let's say we want our firework effect to fade out over time. We would add a scale color module to its particle update stage and set the transparency parameter to go from 100% to 0 over the course of the particle's lifetime. By adding this module to the particle update stage, the functions behind that module get called every frame that our particle gets updated. Next up, we have parameters. These are data storage units. In Niagara, they're used in the same way as you would variables in classes or blueprints. As in variables, parameters are defined using types that specify what type of data the parameter can represent. Earlier, we set the transparency parameter of our firework particle's scale color module, which had a data type of a float and represented how transparent we wanted our particles to be. There are four types of parameters available to you in Niagara: primitives, representing numbers; enums, representing named values; structs, representing a combination of primitives and enums; and data interfaces, which can be used to access almost any type of data which you have in your game, such as meshes and audio. By default, Niagara gives you access to many predefined parameters that get used in some of its built-in modules. You can access these by opening the parameters panel. As you can see, these parameters are split into groups. They're assigned icons to represent the name of the group which owns them. Particle parameters are owned by the particle group, emitter parameters are owned by the emitter group, and so on. You can create custom parameters for each of these groups by pressing the plus icons in the top right corner of those group headers. If you want to be able to change a parameter using Blueprint or C++, you need to create it in the user exposed group. Writing and reading to and from these parameters works in a stacked manner. This table shows which group a module needs to be in to read and write to a parameter from specific groups. The last major component of Niagara is the system. These are containers for one or more emitters, combining them into a complete effect by controlling when and how they get triggered. You can add, duplicate, and modify emitters in a system without making changes to their original asset. As in emitters, you can add parameters and modules to the system's Blue Master node. Also, this is where you'll set the default values for your custom user parameters. The most notable tool in the system suite is the timeline panel, which can be used to manage and compactly show which emitters are contained in the system, as well as when they get executed. If we want our complete firework effect to include a burst of particles at the location where our fireworks are shot from, then we would add an additional emitter to the firework system to produce that effect. Let's create our first Niagara system. Navigate to your content browser, right-click, and select Niagara System. This will open up the Niagara wizard, which lets you create a new empty system or choose from some template. The engine comes with a handful of useful templates, so we'll select this option. Then choose the directional burst system. Give it a name, such as NS underscore firework effect, NS representing Niagara system. Double click this asset. In the parameter panel, select the plus icon to the right of the user exposed variable section. Search for linear color and select it. Name this parameter firework color 01. Now do the same thing, but name the parameter firework color 02. Now select the blue system node. Set your first parameter color to be red and your second one to blue. Now select the initialize particle module in your directional burst spawn stage. Drag your firework color 01 variable from the parameters panel into the color parameter of this module. This will set the burst's color to be the color which we gave to this parameter. Now navigate to your location based ribbons initialize particle module. Press the drop down arrow to the right of the color parameter. This will open up a search bar. Type random range linear color. This will spawn two options, a minimum and a maximum. Select the drop-down to the right of your minimum parameter and search for your firework color 01 variable. Now select it. Then in the maximum, do the same but add the firework color 02 variable. What this will do is set your ribbon's color to be randomly selected between the range of the two colors that we have set. Once you've done this, navigate to your system's timeline. Drag the red line to the end of your emitter's lifetime. Make sure that loop playback range is set and press the play button. If we look in the preview panel, we can see our emitter with the new colors that we have set. If you've made it this far, I've made you this I Learned the Foundations of Niagara from a 300-second YouTube video certificate. which you can download from my Discord and share with your favorite recruiters on LinkedIn. If you're interested in learning how to harness the power of Niagara, then you definitely shouldn't subscribe so that you don't get notified when I release my free series where I teach how to create iconic effects from your favorite video games. P.S. If this video gets 1,000 likes by the end of March, I'll release another video distilling another Unreal Engine framework. Write in the comments what you want this to be about. Have a nice day, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.